first movement only, right? Yeah, okay.
Thank you.
probably spend time with you more with Chopin, because the very well-known piece, everybody knows it, right? Same with Bach, actually. With Bach, maybe just, you know what, in general, everything you play, if you don't do too much of this, that would help you to think in more in line. You see, especially in Bach's music, try not to, I know that your hand is not huge, but still, if when you try to do this, that breaks the line, you know? Try to stay a little bit closer to the piano, right? And another thing, in Bach, we have some parts where polyphony is important. Do you understand what polyphony is? Okay, poly means many, phony means voices. We have more than one voice, right? Good example would be here. Then, that B flat is not the top voice. Because what you play this. Should be, keep the F and go from F. Right? Can we try slowly from the beginning? So you play instead of keep it. Yes. Start again. And then from here. Imagine B flat is not there. Can you play without B flat? Just don't play it. This is how it should sound. Do you understand? Then play B flat now, but play it not so loud. So you can think like this. You have to find two different voices on the top line. Very important for you, okay? And one more thing for you just at home, for your practice. In Bach's music, we usually articulate our touch is different with different note values. 16th notes, like semiquavers, or quavers, or crotchets, usually different. Look, this is your crotchet. It's a longer chord. Then you have quavers, more shorter, right? Then you have again crotchets. Probably wouldn't connect this. It's more like you decide, okay, I play my crotchet this way, my semiquavers this way, and so on. Try this way, look, try to crotchet longer, then shorter, then this is short, this is long, but not connected. Then that's the melody, and here you have a choice. You can play either connecting or you can play stronger, weaker, but not connecting. Probably too complicated, yeah? Too complicated. But anyway, it's something for you to think about. We don't have time to polish this. So polyphony, and look at the touch of different note values, and also try not to do too much of this, right? Let's look at Chopin. First of all, I must say that I'm not used to this edition. Some of the notes, you play correctly, but I'm used to some different notes. It's not your fault at all. Like, for example, when you start, this note here, this, not this. But don't worry about this now, play your notes. We'll talk about music in general, right? Let's start. Before we do the introduction, can you start for me this melody? Okay, that's wonderful. And now this is your tempo. And now start the beginning. Go. That's much better. That is much better. Also, don't exaggerate the length of your last note under the slow. Look. Softer. Then then maybe use soft pedal and play differently. Can you try? First time a bit more. Off. Off. Softer now. Off. Off. Wait. Well done. Off. Okay, okay. Very nice. Very nice sound. You have a very good balance between hands. You have accompaniment softer. This is singing. The only thing is, you, again, you do lots of this, and your melody sounds a bit fragmented. You have many expressions. Try to keep one. Sorry. Still stay there. Still the same phrase. Can we try? Stay there. Stay. Stay. Yes, when you finish this, it's not a complete end of the whole phrase. It's only in the middle. You finish halfway, still going, then maybe a bit more than first time, then here don't change pedal, only there, and maybe if you can change pedal here, later. Play first, we will try now. Let's go from the second, actually from the trill. Change pedal here, look. One harmony, then here in the middle you should change pedal. It's okay, it's okay. Keep going, keep going. Stay with pedal, stay, stay, stay. Your phrase is still in the process of going somewhere. That's very good. Just don't do this too much. Stay there. Maybe with a bit more bass line. Section A finished. Next is section B. Look, this music and this music, they're not the same, right? Can you just start again? Yes. What if you just don't continue, but play a bit of a contrast? Because this is a song, look. Song. And this is not a song, this is a dance. A little bit different. Don't rush the triplet. Triplet, don't rush. different. Back to the song. Yes, the only thing is, when we go back to this legato, to this song, give it to a different instrument. This was a happy one. Major key and minor key. A little bit deeper. Maybe this was violin. This is cello. Mm. Sad, right? And the triplet, don't play too fast. Yeah. Just for me. Yes. Go. Sound here. And then when you arrive there, no need to change pedal. Because what you did this. And it's very naked, like no dress. Still in the dress. Yeah. No, don't change pedal. Right, but if you reduce your hand movements, you hear it more like sort of Spanish music. It's a little bit more sustained, not so bursting, you know, very obviously. Imagine guitar. Yeah, can you try? Just from there. Stay. Much. Try not to pedal. It has to be not so open. Rhythmically correct, but clear. Yes, that's well done. Then the last thing before we finish. When you play the trills again here, what you did incorrectly, you did it in one pedal. You did this. Not so good. Because we have one harmony, another harmony, sorry, and then try to be in time, almost in time, yeah? And the last one, when you finish, try to play a little bit of diminuendo in the left and a little bit of crescendo in the right. Can you try? Okay. Sorry, Akari. Let's do it from here. Very nice. Thank you.